శుక్లం వరధరం విష్ణుం శశివర్ణం చతుర్భుజం ప్రసన్నవదనం ధ్యాయేత్ సర్వవిఘ్నోపశాంతయే. రామాయ రామభద్రాయ రామచంద్రాయ వేధసే రఘునాథాయ నాథాయ సీతాయ పతయే నమః. డియర్ ఫ్రెండ్స్, వి ఆర్ సీయింగ్ వాల్మీకి రామాయణ. వి ఆర్ ఇన్ దిస్ అరణ్యకాండ వేర్ రామ అండ్ లక్ష్మణ హ్యావ్ బీన్ గ్రాబ్డ్ బై దిస్ చాప్ కాల్డ్ కబంధ. We saw a very huge figure with no head. His thighs are broken, thighs are not there, and only a huge torso which is almost resembling like a hillock, such a huge torso is there, and head is actually pressed into the mouth. There is only one eye and a huge mouth with very sharp teeth, and he can only grab and eat, So you can visualize a very headless person, with very, very long hands, yojanayatam, that is a few kilometers. So, such long hands, so that he can grab whatever animal comes within that range, he can grab all those animals and then he can keep on eating. So, what does it symbolize? We can visualize people among us who are indiscriminately grabbing, avaricious, not only gluttonous in physical sense, but also gluttonous in the metaphorical sense. That is, whatever they can grab, they can grab money, they can grab land, they can grab anything. Whatever comes across, they can grab, and indiscriminately they can harass good, bad and all types of people. Like this fellow Kabandha is eating all types of things, including deer he eats, he also eats simha. So, he is capable of devouring everybody. So, such Kabandhas also we come across in our life. So, such Kabandha has grabbed both Rama and Lakshmana. His only job is to just, he has got a very sharp eye. That description was there, very sharp eye, and he can see in a very long range, and then in that long range whatever is seen, he can just grab and take. So, that is what he has done. And now, Rama was actually talking about his destiny. Rama is not scared or anything, he is just talking about this destiny. You see, time seems to be his time. He is personifying that time. Time seems to be such a powerful thing. Kalasya sumahadviryam sarvabhuteshu Lakshmana. O Lakshmana, for all the people, let it be Indra, let it be some other great king, let it be some other great person. The time is something which is teaching them a lesson. Time is actually a certain, it will have a sort of leveling experience on all the people. So, that is what he is saying. And naturally, they can't stay like that for a long time. They make up their mind to somehow weaken this fellow, or to chop off his hands. So, they have not yet thought of chopping off his hands. They have now decided to attack him, so that they can save themselves. Otherwise, this man will devour them. So, this headless Kabandha, then we come to the next sarga, that is 70th sarga. Sarga number 70 in this Aranyakanda, where this fellow is again asking them, who are you? Why are you not speaking to us? So, then Lakshmana is not replying to him. Lakshmana is speaking to Rama, let us cut off his hands, because this fellow is not stopping. He is sure to eat us up. So, let us do something. Then there is a small ethical doubt, ethical dharma samshaya as we call it, dharma sandeha we call it. Dharma sandeha is some sort of ethical question. This fellow, he is not mobile, he does not have legs, and then he is not mobile, he has only very strong hands, and he has got a huge mouth in his belly, and then he is only capable of eating. This fellow is not capable of fighting back except with his hands, there are no legs. So, is it just in such a situation to attack and kill a person? So, that is what that is the doubt. He says, Nishyeshtanam vadho rajan kutsito jagati patehe. Nishyeshtanam vadaha, hey rajan, he is addressing the Rama, O king, it is rather foul, that is kutsitaha. Kutsita means foul. It is very, you see, when in a game, you can play fair and you can also play foul. So, this killing a person who is not very mobile, it is something which is a foul activity. Kutsito jagati patehe kratumadhyopanitanam pashunami varaghava. Like some animals have been tried in order to be sacrificed in a yajna. And it is very improper to take away that particular pashu and then kill elsewhere. So it has to be offered only in that sacrifice or not, it can't be killed like that. So like that, so it is something, nischeshtanam vada, a person who is not mobile, it is very improper to kill. So when they were speaking like that, Kabandha again, Guru was very angry, these fellows, they are not replying to me. On the other hand, they are thinking of cutting off my arms. So he lifts them up and then he tries to eat them. And that is the right opportunity for them also. When they come close, they just chop off the Rama sitting on the right shoulder. He chops off the right shoulder, and Lakshmana sitting on the left side. So he chops off the left shoulder. So that is what they do. And they were in fact Achindatam Susamhrushtav. They were happy to do that because earlier they had that moral dilemma, or rather ethical dilemma. How can we attack a fellow who has not done any harm so far? Now it is very, very sure that they are about to be devoured. When they are about to be devoured, then naturally they had to defend themselves and they cut off his shoulders. Achindantam susamhurushtav bahutasyam sadeshayoho. Never happy to cut off. And say that is how. Then that Rakshasa Kabandha, he makes such a terrible noise that the whole jungle reverberates. The whole forest reverberates with that that huge sound. And now he becomes a Dina. Dina means very, very supplicant and very gentle. And he then asks, "Who are you?" Now Lakshmana reveals who they are. Then he tells about how Rama is that Ikshvakudayado Ramo Nama Janaishrutaha. We are from the Ikshvaku clan. He is a Rama, and then he has been deprived of his kingdom by the evil plan of his mother, the Kaikeyi. Mother means not all the people are considered as mothers only by Rama, not exactly a stepmother. So by the mother Kaikeyi. So he tells all that story. And now he asks, who are you moving as a headless demon? Kabandha kimartham va tvam tu kova kimartham va kabandha sadrusho vane kabandha sadrushaha. That is a totally headless person. How are you moving like this? Then Kabandha at the time he recalled what Indra had told him and what some other muni had told earlier, because this fellow was also in a proper shape earlier. He was a very, very powerful man, very powerful, very handsome person earlier. He recalls that story. Virupam yachame rupam praptam hyavinayadyatha. Virupam means this sort of ugly rupa, this sort of ugly appearance which I have now got. It is because of my avinayam, avinaya. Vinaya means modesty, something different from humility. Humility is slightly lower thing. Modesty is you are very capable and competent, and you have got all that valor in you, but then you are not boasting about yourself. You are modest. That is vinaya. So this vinaya should be there for anybody who has a great virtue. For example, Vidya, a person who is a highly learned man, he should not be going about finding fault with everybody. He should not be going about denigrating everybody. Like, okay, you don't know anything, you are a fool. We should not be talking like that. So that is the reason why there is a shloka there is a Subhashitam by Bhartruhari. Vidya Vivadaya Dhanam Madaya Shakti Paresham Paripidanaya. A bad person, he uses his Vidya for Vivada. He will try to debate with everybody, and he will try to look down on everybody. He will like to denigrate every chap. Dhanam madaya. If money is there, that gives a lot of pride. That gives a lot of pride to people, and he will tick off. I can buy anybody on the face of the earth. So people with money, they have this attitude. They definitely, we see around us. Okay, every fellow has his price, they say. So dhanam madaya. Then Shakti Paresham Paripidanaya. Shakti, if you are a very valorous, if you are a very strong person, that strength a bad person uses for tormenting others, for teasing others, for causing harm to others. So that sort of Paresham Paripidanam. Pidanam means torturing. So that sort of, in that way he uses. But a good man, Shakti Paresham Paripidanaya Khalasya Sadhor Viparitameta. Sadhu, a person who is a sadhu jana, that is a gentleman. Viparitam, this is totally opposite. Jnanaya, danaya, charakshanaya. Vidya, if a person is a learned man, he will try to tell some others, he will try to educate others, he will try to communicate to others, he will try to teach others. So that is his vidya. It is not dying in himself, it is being transmitted to some other people. Then dhanam shakti param, then kalasya sadhor viparit dhan gyanaya danaya danaya. If money is there, he is not holding it and all that, he also gives some money to others. Danaya cha rakshanaya shakti. If you are a very strong man, you are also supposed to protect the meek, protect those who are in danger. So rakshanaya paresham rakshanaya. So that is what Bhartruhari says in that nice subhashita. So like this here, he says, this rupam has been got by me by my avinayam. Avinayam means my arrogance, my sheer a sort of pride and arrogance. So that sort of behavior, this is a sort of punishment for arrogance. So that is what he says, and he is now telling his story. He says, I was a very strong, a very handsome man once upon a time. And rupam asit mama ashintyam trishu lokeshu vishrutam. In all the three worlds my rupam was so famous, and my strength was also so famous. Soham rupamimam krutva rupamidam krutva lokavitrasanam mahat. So such a fellow, a very strong person, a very endowed by nature, endowed by the God with so much of say strength in him, he used to take different shapes. And once upon a time, he also took this shape of a kabandha, that is a headless person with only huge mouth in the tummy, and then with a sharp teeth and only one eye, and then he took such a shape, and he was harassing all the munis, all the sages who were there in the forest. Then one sage, he got angry and then gave a shapam, he gave a curse. Okay, you want to tease us like this, let this shape be for you, with you forever, you be in this shape only forever. So he gave such a shapam. Then this fellow realized, and this fellow fell on his feet, and he gave a sort of some solution, some escape. When is that release? The release from that shapa will be when Rama comes to the forest, and then Rama will deliver you, he will chop off your shoulders, and then at that time you will be delivered. So that is what he recalled, that is what he says. And another time, and some more story he says. Not only that Brahmana, sage who gave that shapam, he had done a lot of tapas. This kabandha had done a lot of tapas, and with that great tapas he propitiated that Lord Brahma. Brahma is there, that creator Brahma. Creator Brahma, as we know, Brahma is a person who will give boons for whatever great effort you do, whatever great work you do, there is a result incommensurate to that work. So that is a nature's law. So that nature's law, we personify it as Brahma. So that Brahma has given him a very long life. And with that long life, so he thought, okay, long life and also a lot of strength, nobody can do anything to me. He once went and attacked Indra. So Indra, after all, he is the head of the gods, and he is supposed to say humble people. So Indra took his weapon, and then with his weapon he just crushed down his head into the torso. So the head went into the torso, only one eye was there, and then the mouth was there. And this fellow, how can I survive? And he also broke the thighs. Then how can I survive? So Indra gave him very long hands, very long and very strong hands, so that he can just look around, say a few kilometers away, and then he can catch anything. So that story also he tells. And Indra didn't kill him because he just wanted to honor Brahma's word, because Brahma had given him a long life. He didn't want to say dishonor Brahma's word, so he did not kill him. So you be like this. So that is how this kabandha is now in this particular form, just waiting to get rid of that particular body. He is somehow aware of that thing, and he is trying to get rid of that body. So that is what he says. Dehanyasa kurta shramaha. Dehanyasa kurta shramaha means deha nyasa. I just want to give up this body, and then I am trying to grab everything so that at some point of time I will grab Rama. So that is what he says. At some point of time, if I keep on grabbing everything it comes to my hand and then trying to eat, at some point of time Rama will be caught. So luckily for me, by my great fortune, you have caught me, and then you have cut off my shoulder, then and I will be able to. And that Maharshi had also told, only Rama will be able to defeat you, nobody else will be able to defeat you. So shakyo hantum yatha tattvam eva muktam maharshina, by you alone I will be defeated. So then aham hi matisachivyam karishyami narashava, I will do Mati Sachivyam. Valmiki uses a nice expression here. Mati Sachivyam. Sachiva, you know. We know what is Sachiva. Sachiva means a minister, a counselor, an advisor. He is what is Sachiva. Mati Sachivyam is that the state of being a Sachiva. That is a person who is a counselorship, let us say. So, Mati Sachivyam means I will help you in your thinking. In the sense, I will be able to guide you, I will be able to say you what you have to do. I will do Mati Sachivyam Karishyami, Mitram Chaiva Upadekshyami. I will also tell you how you can get, how you can achieve your task. Because Lakshmana has told them what is his problem. Lakshmana had told them, Sita has been, that also he told, Sita has been carried away by a fellow called Ravana. We are just now looking for that Ravana, we do not know where he is. So, that is what he said. So, this Kabandha, he realized that these people are in need of some sort of help from someone who knows some area, and then someone who can also do some sort of recce and all that. So, he said, Aham Mati Sachivyam Karishyami, I will help you in building a strategy. Mati Sachivyam is just helping to build a strategy, and I will tell you with whom you have to befriend. Rama, he also explains his position, eva muktastu dharmatma idam jagada vachanam. So, then he says, how is Sita taken away, we only know the name, nama matram tu janami, I only know the name, but we don't know where exactly that fellow stays, nivasam va prabhavam va vayam tasya navidmahe, we do not know where he stays, we do not know what exactly is his prabhava means his capabilities. And we are not aware of what exactly it is, and you can definitely help us, because we are also helping you to get rid of this shapa, to get out of this shapa, because once Rama chops off the hand, that shapa will be over. So, that is what they had told. Then this he says, you please cremate me, burn this body before sunset. In this rupam, I don't have that divya drushti, in this appearance as Kabandha, in this particular form, I don't have that divya drushti. If you burn me, I will get back into my original shape, and in that original shape, I have my divya drushti, so that I can just think, and then I can see, and then I can guide you where you have to go, and then whom you have to meet. So, but broadly, he says, I will be able to help you. So, he says, divya drushti, divyamasti name jnanam abhijanami maithilim. Right now, I am not able to see where Sita is. It is somewhat like this, some people do this anjanam, and then they say, okay, Sita is there in that particular place, away, hidden in such a place. So, some sort of divya drushti this chap is having. He says, in this body, I don't have. Once this, I can dispose of this body, then I will have that divya drushti. So, you please set fire to this body, so that I will get back that thing, and I will also tell you about a person who knows the whole world. I will just scan, and then I will tell you about who will be able to help you. And then we come to the next sarga, that is 72nd, sarga number 72. So, what Rama and Lakshmana, what do they do? They choose a valley, because this fellow is so huge. He cannot be set fire. They can't put all the wood and firewood and all that. So, they just chose a small valley, and into that valley they put this fellow's body, and then put lot many dry sticks, and they set fire to that. And from that fire, a big divine body came out, and also along with that a divine chariot also came. Vimane bhasvare tishthan hamsa yukte yashaskare. So, this chap, he immediately got a very divine body, and there was a divine chariot. He got onto the divine chariot, which was stationed in the air, and from there he spoke to Rama. And now he says, Shrunu raghava tatvena yatha sitam avapsyasi. Then he just thinks for a while, and then he says, oh Raghava, Raghava means oh Rama, I am telling you, just listen. Rama shadyuktayo loke yabhis sarvam vimrushyate. There are six types of strategies which a king has to adopt. Shad yuktayaha. There are six types of strategies. And among those strategies, there is one strategy called samashraya. Samashraya is when you are not in a very perfect shape, when you are in some small problems, you have to befriend another person who also is in some problem, so that he needs your help and you need his help. You are not totally dependent on him and he is not totally dependent on you, and your friendship is on equal terms. So that is what he says. What are these six strategies? The six strategies are what is called sandhi. Then sandhi is making friendship. If a person, suppose a king wants to achieve some target, achieve some objective that he wants to achieve, he wants to be victorious with another, with one enemy. So then he has to make friends with some neighboring kings, and then with their help he has to go and attack his enemy. That is what is called sandhi. Then second one is vigraha. Vigraha means actual enmity goes on. Actual enmity, you are having that enmical terms which are very clearly defined and you are very clear. Actual enmity is very much there, but right now war is not there. Number three is yanam. Yanam means you make all preparations. You protect your, make preparations for protecting your fort and what not. All the domestic defenses are very much in place, and then you take a nice army and then you go and attack. That is what is called yanam. And the other one is dvaidhi bhava. Dvaidhi bhava is creating enmity in the enemy rank. In the enemy rank, you have to sow some seeds of discontent. That is creating, say, what we call divisive elements will be there. So you have to divide that force. And the sixth one is samashraya or samshraya. It is a situation where you are in some small distress. So you have to find somebody who is in equal distress. So he is suggesting that samshraya. Parimrushto dashantena dashabhagena sevyate. Parimrushto dashantena, somebody who is affected by this sort of dashanta. Dashanta means the culmination of your bad dasha. What we call, we talk about, this fellow is not, this fellow's dasha is not good. Dasha means a particular, say, the state of affairs, let us say, the loose translation is the plight, the situation. That is, it is not so good, that situation is not so good. So, dashantena, a person whose plight is not very good, he has to take the help of a person who is equally in distress. So, that is what he suggests. And he says, right now, you are in a bad shape. You are in a bad shape. Dashabhagato hinaswam hi rama salashmanaha. You are now in a bad shape. And you have to find somebody who is equally in distress. So, let me search who is that person. So, he does some sort of mental scanning, and I do not see any other way, he says, apart from making friends with somebody who is quite strong enough, not only in distress. A fellow in total distress, he will be of no use. He should be strong enough to help you. He should be equally strong, a person who is equal in stature to you. So, that is what he has to look for. So, he looks for, and now he says, Shruyatam Rama Vakshyami Sugrivo Nama Vanaraha. Okay, now listen, there is one person like this who is capable of helping you, who is also having some problem, and then he wants some help, and I will tell about that person to you. So, now he is going to tell about what is Sugriva, what are his capabilities, and how he is going to help, and where exactly he is located, and how you have to walk towards that place. So, all that he is going to tell, we will see in the next episode. Harihi Om Tat Sat.